Did you hear that? It's time. We need to go even deeper.
Oh, good. Was this Iron Man?
Are you sure about this? Initiating sequence 2-2012. Good luck.
What the fuck?
School. School is great. It's where you learn.
The more you learn, the more you earn.
What am I earning? Knowledge.
Boom, there it is.
And I'm
the best person to ever exist.
Okay.
It's 2012. The world is ending, the crops are burning, and everything is going to shit. Society was in chaos, and news of our impending doom spread like wildfire.
Fortnite warning.
Spoiler alert. We all died back in 2012.
Thank God for that.
Except for three Chinese postgraduates from the Shanghai Jiao Tong University.
Okay.
Their plan to save the world, cure for cancer, sustainable energy,
anime girls,
reverse engineering immortality, maybe
anime
deleting
girls.
Twitter.
Anime girls.
No. Cute anime girls.
Oh my god.
Back in 2011,
yep, there it is.
Before miHoYo was
thought.
Officially established, Liu Wei and two of his friends were in a business startup competition. They had to pitch their business to investors for a chance to win a cash prize or investment capital. The higher you place, the bigger the rewards.
Makes sense.
They were a three-man team who shared an interest of otaku culture and ACG, which stands for animation, comics, and games.
Wait,
and
is
let
that
me
a...
tell you.
Oh no, is that what I think it is?
ACG. They were a three-man team who shared an interest of otaku culture.
She's like, oh no.
And ACG.
Oh god.
Which stands for animation, comics, and games. And let me tell you, the boys went into the competition with a plan. Convert everyone there into weebs.
Our core product is an anime-themed mobile game. It is a gameplay on smartphones or tablets based on anime-style characters, as the characters are mainly cute and-
Is that Dr. Phil? I think this is Dr. Phil.
My girls, this kind of game is popular among the otaku. Therefore, our core users are otakus. We understand otakus because we ourselves are otakus. Besides the interesting game point, gamers can develop their own virtual characters and also their
Dr.
virtual
Phil, TTS.
Fuck you! What to the fuck is this weeb shit?
Okay, maybe the last part might be a little bit exaggerated, but I don't know what's more surprising. The fact that he really said cute anime girls.
Wait. Wait, no. He actually said this. Oh. Oh, I thought this was a meme. As the characters are mainly cute anime girls, this kind of game is popular among the otakus. Parentheses, recluse. Therefore, our core users are otakus, and we understand them because we are otakus. Holy fuck. They're not even ashamed. They're not sorry. They own it.
In a business startup tournament. Or the fact that he got third place. Around the same time as the tournament, miHoYo made their first game titled Fly Me to the Moon.
Probably the guy that
it was
the
only available on the App Store for iOS. And the last update was, let's just say it was a couple weeks ago. Mm-hmm. So unless you got one of these bad boys, you can't even fly
those.
Me to the moon. Want to know what's so good about this game? I'll give you a few seconds. You done? Yeah, it's better than Angry Birds. Yeah, that's right. That boring game where you shoot chickens at trees got nothing. That don't got shit on small jetpack Kiana. And don't take it from me. Take it from the real Pikachu, who said, and I quote, "Get if you like anime, Well, shit. This game is surprisingly fun. It has four worlds, each with an okay amount of levels. My one gripe I have with this game is the price.
Oh,
I felt like it's a little too much, but if you like anime, you will like this game. Also, I didn't get bored with this game, which like Angry Birds, and I wanted to finish and get all three stars.
Thank you. 25 cents has been deposited into your account. Please post another review for further funds.
Oh, you heard it here, boy. And there you have it. There it is. miHoYo's first game ever created managed to beat Angry Birds, but then I was like, wondering, 4 stars?
Yeah.
Which got me thinking, how much did this game cost that even Pika Weka was like, no. Well, reading some of the reviews,
it was
like $3. Someone
Damn.
Even said that they'll...
So basically, what we're saying here is that Vampire Survivors in 10 years is going to have anime girls, microtransactions, and gacha, because that's how much Vampire Survivors was, too. This is only the beginning.
Buy the game, even if it was $5, so you know what that means. Fly Me to the Moon is the best mobile game of 2011.
Wow.
Big W for miHoYo that year as an indie developer. Their first game was made by 5 people. That's
incredible.
One more than Pikachu's review. So, the year is back to 2012. miHoYo, third in the tournament, and their first game being objectively better than Angry Birds. They looked towards creating another game, but this time they weren't some random indie game dev from China, but a random official indie game dev from China. This was the year miHoYo was formally incorporated, and they had taken
Wait,
a deal-
Wait, Takotaku Save the World? I love how they're just not even ashamed of this at all. Like, they don't give a fuck, man. They're like, yeah, this is what we're about.
With Sky Mobi, which is a
like
publisher in China who hosts your games through their own app store. The deal? Oh, you know, we give you $150,000, just
that's
a little bit of money,
good
in
money.
Exchange for a 15% stake in the company. So, having to deal with the sudden investment into their new company,
those guys made a good call. That was a very, very good call.
miHoYo had to make their next game a banger, a slapper, a McDabber to not disappoint their investors.
A McDabber?
So, their next game
I've never seen that
will
before.
Be called Zombie Gao Kawaii. That's an
yeah,
interesting name.
I wonder what this is. Is this gothic anime girls?
The game was not that successful. miHoYo had to do something quick because their situation was not kawaii.
Uh-oh.
2013 was the shittiest year for miHoYo. Their first game as an official company flopped, and the team was living off a salary of $620. You want to know what their ex-schoolmates were earning? About triple, quadra, penta, times their own earnings.
Right.
Time? Running out. Money? Running out. Anime girls? Not running out. But miHoYo would spend this whole year developing their next game, hoping for a miracle, because they're gonna need it.
Mm-hmm.
Let me ask you a question. What would you do if you were in an apocalyptic world and all of your friends got turned into zombies? Well, obviously, you would open up the App Store or Play Store and
I would try to, like, capture all of them and then put them in, like, a turbine-like unit that I would then use resources to cause them to run in order to have them power and generate electricity as zombies. Yeah, I would want to collect them and harness their power, like Pokemon. And that way I wouldn't have to pay an electricity bill after everybody in the electricity building is a zombie.
Rise up, and you would play Gun Girl Z. They basically
okay.
took the budget of Zombie Gal Kawaii and maxed it out. Graphics?
Got it.
Max. miHoYo's team size? Increase.
Wow.
Voice acting? Where? Cute anime girls? We do a little bit of cloning.
Holy
Their budget
shit.
Could use some maxing.
Look at them all.
This game was the make or break for miHoYo. They had spent almost all their investment funds and years developing the game, that if it went the same fate as Zombie Gal Kawaii, this might be their last year. But it wasn't. The debut of Honkai Gakuen 2 in China saw it ranked number 1.
Wow.
And number 9 for the App Store's paid game and popular game, respectively. Easy clap. Their other servers, such as the Sea and Global, were...
What's nuts to me about this is, like, you know how every single game back, like, 2 years ago was a battle royale? And then everybody was trying to make, like, the next MMO. And, like, then they kind of fell out of favor? I wonder if these anime game, like, this anime game style is ever going to fall out of favor. Now, I don't know if it ever will, because, like, this is the new meta. Yeah, it's timeless. Yeah, I don't know if it will.
Weren't doing too bad as well. Their reason for success? Well, they were making an otaku game, so girls are important.
Yeah.
Said one of the founders. The concept of ACG...
Wait, what did he say?
Said...
So girls, we are making an otaku game, so girls are an important element. Which features a legion of cute, gun-wielding girls battling futuristic robots. Well, I saw where... I guess I know where Nikki came from now. Yep, there we go.
One of the founders. The concept of ACG was blowing up in China around this time. I guess the market for cute anime girls wasn't really a thing yet over there. Wow, they really missed out. You want to know another reason for Honkai Gakuen 2's success? Here comes the money. Should I even tell you? It should be pretty obvious by now, right?
Gotcha time, yep.
We asked ourselves why we would want a pin. It's because we love a certain virtual character that we become willing to pay for her.
My guy was changing the...
Did he actually say that? He said that. Got it.
Chinese mobile game meta at the time. The meta at the time was gamers being ranked 1, gamers outperforming each other, gamers being at the top of the leaderboard. S-sports. But Father Liu, a man with God and anime on his side, came into the scene filled with sweaty tryhards and gave everyone a cute anime girl. Because instead of fighting for rank 1, why can't we all be rank 1? Hey, what up, YouTube squad? I managed
to... Well, you just spend money to be rank 1. It's even better.
Teleport back into 2014 to try out this new game called, I think it was called Gun Girl Z. I think this is a game made by Rovio Entertainment, so let's check it out. Ignore the Chinese spyware harvesting my data. First, I'm gonna go download the game so I can play it. So we're gonna go into the App Store, search Gun Girl Z. And there it is. Yeah, we're gonna click on it to download so we can download the game.
1 million downloads. Holy shit. Okay, so it's just, yep, got it.
Okay, guys, I'm back after finishing the whole lore of the...
Well, this is so popular now. Like, I was watching Log Horizon, and there's this girl in the show, and she's like... pretty much, like, nearly a background character. But the entire ending credit scene is all about her. Because she's, like, the most, like, you know, the most important girl in the show. Yep, there you go. The ninja girl, yep. Akatsuki.
Rings any minute now. Why am I getting achievement?
Well, 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 what do we have here? Kiana returns once again. Woo-woo!
I will not be a friend of you. For a game made in 2014, it's actually not that bad. I mean, it's better than Angry Bird. I just realized I'm a 2-year-old shooting zombies to find my lost dad. Meanwhile, there's a fucking alien with a hammer.
I love how, yeah, she didn't move the back.
This game is really relaxing.
Oh, yeah. Great game.
Oh, shit. Here we go, guys. The real gacha. Let's see if I'm gonna pull some crazy 5 stars.
What? Oh, wow.
No!
Alright, guys, I think I'm done with this game. I'm gonna go buy my account so I don't lose my progress. Hopefully it's not something like Facebook only. That would ruin my experience. 3 years. 150 million United States dollars. 7 people. With their new success...
That's a lot of fucking money, bro. We need to make one of these games. Like, we gotta fucking... We gotta get behind this. Like, we gotta get on this train. Holy fuck.
success, miHoYo moved on to their next game, Honkai Impact 3rd.
This
Can I say something
real
quick? As a person who has never played any games made by miHoYo before Genshin, this shit is like the next fate.
I'm fucking dying right now.
You got my ass jumping around with all these versions that are very similar, mm-hmm. but not really. Like, for example, Honkai Impact 3rd. Honkai Impact 3. Honkai 3rd. Honkai Gakuen 2. Honkai 2nd. Guns Girl. Honkai Gakuen. Guns Girl.
It's all
School
the, wait,
Day
what
Z.
The fuck?
Gun Girl Z. Mirage Cabin. Guns Girl Z. Escape Ragnarok. Zombie Gal Kawaii. Mm-hmm. Electric Boogaloo. Zombie Gal Kawaii. Honkai Gakuen 1. And Fly Me to the Moon. These are just four games. Is this miHoYo or is this Type Moon? I don't know. Honestly,
so they just have a bunch
I could just add some
names
related
game.
To school or zombie, and it would look like a miHoYo game. Like, let's see. High School of Dead, The End of School.
Yep, that's about right.
Wait a minute.
I could see
Honkai
that.
Honkai Gakuen 2, formerly known as... Who is in charge of naming all these games? This guy? I feel like there's so many different thingies for the same thingies. I could make, like, multiple theories about all the universes.
It doesn't matter what you call it. Because it's people are still going to play it because it's got hot anime girls. Their boobs have more physics than the bosses in the game. Like, let's just be honest here. Like, that's why we're here. I mean, come on.
Then this but game. That's just a game theory. Honkai Impact 3rd did good. I'm talking 1 million downloads in Japan 11 days after release good.
Yeah, it was very
Although
popular.
The game was released in 2016. It wouldn't be available globally until...
It actually got released last year. Actually, sorry, this year, earlier in the West, and they renamed it to Tower of Fantasy.
2018. So what happened here?
Okay, what happened?
Oh, shit. Buckle in your seatbelts, because this... It's gonna be a long one. Development of Genshin began in late January 2017. The team had grown from 7 people to 120 to
wow.
400 at the end of the year. The cost to make
That's
this
a lot.
Game was 100 million USD. That's more than this. And this.
Holy fuck.
And these.
Bro, how do you spend so much money just making an anime game like that? What the hell is it? Where the hell is it going?
You guys know Zelda, right? June 2019.
Where the hell's it going?
E3. miHoYo revealed to the world their next game called Genshin Impact.
I am here to talk about
Genshin Impact.
Naturally, gamers were very supportive, wholesome, and excited for this game to come out.
Oh yeah.
As a matter of fact, one gamer was so excited that on a sunny day, he decided to wake up, drive to the PlayStation booth promoting Genshin Impact at China Joy, and he slammed his PS4 into the ground? Oh. Into the...
Bro, this dude is so fucking mad. He's like, how dare you throw that on the ground? What is wrong with you, you piece of shit? Why did he do that? Yeah, like, why did he throw it on the ground like this? I don't understand. He was a Zelda fan? Wait, so he walked up to all of the fucking Asian-looking people, and he threw his PS4 on the ground because he was... Jesus! Oh my fucking God, this is a grown-ass man! This is the new Top G.
Oh. I guess his day wasn't so Sony after all. He wasn't the only guy, by the way. Gamers were mad. Really mad at miHoYo yeah. and Sony for copying Breath of the Wild.
Oh, absolutely.
And while the expo received a lot of hate from gamers, online was even worse. Get your hazmat suits and brace yourselves.
We're entering Chernobyl levels of radiation.
Oh, people were fucking furious about this because they had stolen a number of things, at least from what people say. I didn't play Breath of the Wild, so I'm not 100% sure. But, like, a lot of things seemed like they were stolen from Breath of the Wild. I mean, to me, it's like if you bring out a game, people are going to do the same fucking thing. If it sells well, that's just the way it goes. Yeah, that's the way it goes. You like it or not?
Shit! The air in here smells like dog shit. How could anyone live in here?
It's the YouTube comments section area.
Anyway, as I was saying, a lot of gamers, especially on China's end, were just radioactive. I looked through some of the Weibo comments about the PS4 Genshin announcement, and I could feel my chair slowly turning into salt from all of the tears coming from these gamers. Hate speech, family insults, that shit was everywhere. It gave me flashbacks to solo queue League of Legends. If there was one thing I learned about reading through these comments, is that they could write essays about the gaming industry in China, but somehow still manage to insult my mother in three different ways.
Yes.
Obviously, I'm not gonna show it. And also, these messages were read with shitty translation, so it's not the most accurate. Even if I don't understand Chinese completely, I kinda sensed that my whole family was being attacked. I am convinced that when you are this overdosed on hate, you lose like 99% of your brain cells because someone accused Sony of their crimes for plagiarism when they didn't even make the game.
You've been... Nobody gives a fuck. The thing is, people get mad about this shit for no reason. I don't know why, like, the gamers go out of the way. We have to defend the intellectual property right of this fucking multi-billion dollar company. Who cares? If the game's good, then play it. If it's bad, don't play it. Well, this is not your fucking problem. Great War of Genshin's launch. Yeah. Following clips are real. Oh my god.
Wow! This new game looks so fun! I can't wait for it to come out and play it!
Shut the fuck up! How are you supporting this game when it's a direct copy of Breath of the Wild? Did you know that miHoYo fucked my wife and so my-
Listen up, you little shit. This is why I hate you, Nintendo gamers, so much. You shove Nintendo down everyone's throat and we'll never hear the end of it. You think every game is a masterpiece with no flaws? I think you should stick to your Mario games.
Uh-huh.
Wow! This new game looks so fun!
And stop following me!
I understand that Genshin is very similar. Sometimes... You know, the
inspiration... Bro, they lifted it. Who cares? Like, this is just what happens. It's like, for example, who was it? Was it Hassan or XQC who first started watching MasterChef? Then everybody started watching MasterChef. Then, whenever I think it was Soda started doing Media Share, then it was... How did I possibly fucking forget Gordo? Oh my fucking god. Yes, it was Trainwreck who did it like 6 months before anybody else. Everybody started watching it. Remember whenever it was Shroud that like donated like $5,000 to Trainwreck to tell him to stop the intro and start watching Gordo? Yeah, it was like, fuck it. This was a very important moment. And so anyway, everybody started watching Gordo. And then you had 90 Day Fiancé. Alinity still watches that shit. Because then everybody else was watching it. People love watching her watch it. And then whenever the trial was happening, at first, I think it was XQC started watching it. Then I'm like, oh, I'm going to start watching it too because this seems like it's good for him. I'm going to see if it's good for me. Turns out it was. Then other people start watching it after I start watching it. Then Soda does Media Share. Soda makes $5,000 in a day. Every other fucking streamer's like, hey, you know what? Fuck Sellout Sunday. We're going to do Welfare Wednesday. And then guess what? Everybody starts doing that. Then, oh, look at this. Fortnite's really popular. Oh, this guy's playing Fortnite. Let's see what Fortnite's like. Let's everybody play Fortnite. And then, oh, wow, what's this Dark and Darker game? Huh, this is interesting. Other people are playing this game. I'll start playing it too. Everybody copies everybody. That's the way it goes. If somebody thinks something is doing well, remember whenever I first started playing Dark Souls and I got a lot of viewers for it? And then soon after that, five other people started playing Dark Souls. You think that's a fucking coincidence? Whenever I started playing Final Fantasy, then a bunch of other people started playing it again. You think it's a fucking coincidence? No, it's not. People see it works for one person, then they do it. Everybody else does it. That's the way it goes. Like, that's how the market is. What do you want me to say?
inspiration, maybe too much inspiration, but I'm struggling to see why anyone would care this much.
They're stupid. That's why they're stupid. They're stupid. There's not. Most things can be explained by somebody being dumb. That's all there is to it. Yeah, it's not like some kind of like fucking complex, like, you know, like what's inside his mind? Nothing, bro. It's like a bird cage and a bird's dead inside the brain. Nothing's going on. Just dumb as hell.
It's not like Breath of the Wild invented cell shading or rock climbing.
No, first game that did that was like Beautiful Joe. But to be fair, like Legend of Zelda pretty much popularized it because they had cell shading with Wind Waker, and that was the first. Like Beautiful Joe was like really popular, right? But like Wind Waker came out, and like Wind Waker was like the definitive cell shading game.
And Jet Set like Radio. Even, oh, I forgot about that. Even if you're a Breath of the Wild fan, you would be pretty happy to know that you get to play a new game similar to your favorite game, but
yeah,
I don't
exactly.
know, maybe that's just me. And also,
that's what I thought too.
Genshin is coming to the Switch.
No.
Hi, welcome to the strip club. Hi, welcome to class. Back in 2019, June 25th, miHoYo made a post detailing the production of this game. Mm-hmm. Not a lot of people know about this because, well, it's in Chinese, and this was before E3 and the PlayStation promotion. So I'm pretty sure only like 5 people saw this. I sacrificed 2 children to find this post. With the power of $2 translation, what the fuck? I was able to deduce that Company B is Bethesda in Chinese.
Okay.
Hey, you. Finally.
miHoYo modeled Genshin's quest system after looking at Fallout and Skyrim's quest system. Random World Event took notes from random events in GTA. World Exploration came from Breath of the Wild.
Yeah.
Basic Combat from Honkai 3rd. Naughty Dogs because why not? And Elemental Combat was from Divinity Original Sin 2.
So they just stole everything from other games. Yeah, that's the way it goes. Of course. Yep. That's what the thing is. What you have to remember is like all of these other previous games like Divinity Original Sin, a lot of the things that they probably have in their game were stolen from games before that. And then Warcraft, they stole things from Warhammer. And then Warhammer stole things from fucking like things like Lord of the Rings and Tolkien and Dungeons and Dragons. And then they stole things from Tolkien. It's everybody's stealing from everybody. This is just how things go. People get
I'm not pulling this out of my ass. This is literally from the production team who designed Genshin Impact.
Smart.
So yes, miHoYo officially stated that they used Breath of the Wild to model the world of Genshin.
Smart. It was a good world.
$100 million.
That's crazy.
That's the cost to make Genshin. They made that back in 2 weeks.
Wow.
Pokemon Go. You guys know Pokemon?
Imagine being those guys that invested in the company for $150,000 for 15%. That dude, man, whoever made that call, oh, bro, like, that was a good decision.
Pokemon. You guys remember when that game came out? Everyone and their grandma knew about it.
What do you think it's named?
I don't know, a strawberry?
You would go outside and try to collect all these Pokemanes to one-up your friends.
I don't know, a strawberry?
I've never played this game. It took 9 months for Pokemon Go to hit 1 billion. Genshin took 6. These figures that I'm talking about did not include sales from PC or console.
Holy fuck.
Let that sink in. $1 billion on this. I don't even know anyone who plays on mobile. Correction. I don't know anyone at all. miHoYo is a very successful game, and I'm sure that a lot of people can see how much effort went into this game. There were some interesting controversies that I did not cover in this video, but I can't deny
I don't even know
that Genshin has given me so much hours of entertainment.
Wouldn't gliding be
a gacha game. Anime Waifu Printer had a budget that rivals AAA game developers.
I don't like, where did that money go? That's what I'm curious, like, where did that money go, man?
Like, miHoYo is not the best company, but at least they don't recycle the same game annually and change the title to the current year. The CEO of miHoYo had the vision. He saw the untapped market of paying for anime characters back in 2014. Mm-hmm. In 2014, I was doing fuck all. We came from this?
Yeah, he knew people were losers, and nobody wanted to believe him. So he proved it.
To this, the way better game. If you want to thank anyone, thank Small Jetpack Kiana. Wait, did you see that? Wait, hold up. Go back real quick. What was that? Enhance. Holy shit. This was here the whole time? Hold the phone. I'm holding it. Let's see here. Fly me to the moon. Fuck.
Frank Sinatra.
Okay. Genshin release date. Oh my god.
They released it on the same day.
The people who made Genshin are the same people who made Fly Me to the Moon. Coincidence?
Imagine that.
I think not.
Okay.
Hello there. So, thanks for making it all the way to the end of the video. Before you say anything, I know miHoYo has another game called Theories of Temis where you date hot dudes. I just can't be fucked. I've been working on this video for the past
month. Yeah, nobody played that one.
And I'm currently dead inside. Anyways, hope you enjoyed the video. Before the music runs out, thank you for 50k subs. It means a lot to me that you guys watched.
Damn, he's almost at 100k now.
Bye-bye, take care.
Alright, so I think this was a pretty good video. This was a surprisingly good video. I didn't really know if it was going to be any good or not, but this actually gives me a lot of insight into the history of these kinds of games. And they're actually coming out with a new game, too. I don't know when it's going to get released. I have no idea. It's like Zenith Zone Zero or something like that. I don't know. I'll probably try it out whenever it comes out. Yeah, it's like three new games. Exactly. It's like, yeah, it's basically the same thing, but it's like, you know, in like space or some fucking shit. I have no idea. Oh my god, you know, story and development is game development. Tell me it's quite interesting. Yeah, I mean, whenever I eventually play Genshin Impact, because, you know, the tweet did, it's like, look, it won. Almost 1 million people saw this poll, and almost 250,000 people voted in this poll. So yes, we will play Genshin Impact. And whenever we do, I will actually play through the story. I'll play through the story, I will see what the game has to offer, and actually try to give it a fair shot. I'll go ahead and link the video for you guys to give them a like and a sub. I think this is a pretty good video. I'll give it a like and subscribe myself. So yeah, I'm excited, man. Don't give the CCP money. Bro, I mean, like, Riot's owned by Tencent. I mean, how are you going to complain about miHoYo whenever Riot is 100% owned by Tencent? I mean, that's fine if you want to be consistent and say, like, any... And, like, also, guess what? Path of Exile, 10% of PoE, is owned by Tencent, too. Yeah, think about that. Yeah, exploration is huge, though. Easily 300 hours. Not like me, man. I'm going to do that in 3 hours. I'm going to get everything done that fast. Tencent owns everything. Tencent is a massive fucking company. It is huge. So, yeah, that's what I think.